So let's do a code walkthrough for the example file OperatorsCasting.java. We took a look at this already in the lecture notes, but let's look at it in a little more detail. So let's focus our attention first on the top half of the file. What we're doing here is we're setting some tax rates. We're setting a float variable and a double variable to the same value, 0.05, but one has a higher precision than the other one. Then we've got a companion variable of a different type for each one. And notice what we're doing here. We're assigning a float value to a double value, which is fine because a float is of lower precision than a double. So that's not going to be any problem. In fact, we can compile this and show that that's the case. But this other example, which is commented out, this isn't going to work. So let's enable this line, and we'll comment out this line. We'll save our changes, and let's see what happens now. Let's clear our window, try to compile it. Uh-oh, compiler's telling us there's a problem, a possible loss of precision on line 29. And that happens because we're trying to stuff a double value into a lower precision float value. That's not going to work. So let's restore this file to what it was before. We'll comment out the bad line, re-enable the good line, clear the output window, save our changes, and let's look at the rest of this file. Here we're looking at averaging. And let's say that we've got a sum of scores, which we've declared to be an int, and a count of those scores, which is also an int. And let's say we've read those in from someplace, and we're trying to average those. We'd expect this to give us an average of 92.6, right? So here's a couple ways of going about it. First of all, here's the wrong way to do it. One int divided by another int is going to give us an int value because both operands of this divide operator are integers. So this is going to be integer division, which is going to give us a whole numbered result of 92, not the expected result of 92.6, even though the average score was declared as a double precision value. So we recognize that we might need some casting here. So here's another attempt at doing it, but this is going to give us the wrong result for a different reason. Here, notice that parentheses have the highest precedence, so this operation is going to take place first, but this is simply the same operation as before. The horse is already out of the barn here. We're doing integer division, so we're getting an integer result, and we're taking that integer and just slapping some decimal accuracy on it to get 92.0. This too is going to give us the wrong answer. The right way to do this is to cast one of the operands only to a double. That turns this into a mixed type expression. So we've got a double divided by an int. By the rules we've discussed, this int is going to be temporarily promoted up to a double. So now we're doing floating point arithmetic. This is going to give us a double result. It's going to give us 92.6 as we expect. And that's going to get stored in our average score variable. We can do the same thing by casting the other operand, doesn't matter which one, as long as only one of them is cast into a double. So let's compile this code. We'll set a breakpoint on main, and let's step through this. So we've got 92 in this result. This also is going to give us an incorrect result of 92, but this one is going to give us the intended 92.6, as will this one. So this is the right way to do averaging using integers. Cast only one of the operands. Before leaving this example, I want to make one final point. You might be wondering, hey, if I need to use a cast operator to get around this problem with integer division giving me a whole numbered result, why not just go back up here and turn these ints for sum of scores and count of scores into doubles and then dispense with the casting in the first place? While that is a quick and dirty solution, and it will give you the right result also, it's really not the best way to go about things. Keep in mind that this sum of scores and the count of scores are inherently whole numbered values, so they truly belong as integer values. It's better to keep the data in the native form that it belongs in and handle the precision down here in the calculation using casting. So this is the way to go about it when you're doing integer averaging.